Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. A leading Jewish lawyer and his partner have said they are leaving the UK after being bombarded by anti-Semitic abuse and death threats by Jeremy Corbyn supporters. Mark Lewis, an ex-Labour supporter who represented victims in the phone hacking case, and Mandy Blumenthal said they are planning to move to Israel by the end of the year. They accused Mr Corbyn of moving the rock anti-Semites have crawled out from, and said they have received a growing wave of hate and threats since he became Labour leader. Mr Lewis said a man has been sent to prison for threatening to kill him simply because he is Jewish. He told the BBC's Victoria Derbyshire show, "The online abuse might continue, the Israelis might not like me because I am too left, might not like me because they think I am too right, whatever their view. But they are not going to dislike me because I am Jewish. And there is only so much you can take when you are getting threats to kill you. When you are getting threats from people that they want you to be ill, etc., it's a drip-drip effect." Mark Lewis, an ex-Labour supporter who represented victims in the phone hacking case, and Mandy Blumenthal, pictured on the BBC's Victoria Derbyshire show on Wednesday, said they are planning to move to Israel by the end of the year. They accused Jeremy Corbyn, pictured in Mansfield yesterday, of moving the rock anti-Semites have crawled out from, and said they have received a growing wave of hate and threats since he became Labour leader. Their intervention piles further pressure on Mr Corbyn, who is facing a barrage of criticism that he tolerates anti-Semites and is failing to tackle the abuse. Labour is being plunged into a bitter civil war over the crisis which could see the party split for good. Mr Lewis said that Britain was once seen as a safe place against anti-Semitism, but the abuse engulfing Labour has spilled out into wider society. Why is Labour's new code of conduct on anti-Semitism so controversial? The Labour anti-Semitism row erupted again after the party leadership refused to fully adopt the International Holocaust Remembrance Alliance's IHRA definition. The party's code explicitly endorses the IHRA definition, but it omits four examples from the IHRA list, accusing Jewish people of being more loyal to Israel than their home country, claiming that Israel's existence as a state is a racist endeavor, requiring higher standards of behavior from Israel than other nations, and comparing contemporary Israeli policies to those of the Nazis. Labour insisted that while the examples are not reproduced word for word, they are covered in the new code. But critics say the decision allows anti-Semitism to continue to fester. And many Jews are considering leaving Britain for Israel, where they know they will not get the same racist abuse, he said. Ms. Blumenthal said, "What's happened here in Britain is to make us not feel safe, as there has been a total climate change. It has become acceptable to be anti-Semitic." She added, "It's not just Jeremy Corbyn and it's not all of the Labour Party, but it's a very, very loud part of it that has enabled this anti-Semitism to fester here in the UK and go throughout society." Her husband added, "Jeremy Corbyn moved the rock and the anti-Semites crawled out from underneath the rock. They are not going back." The couple accused the Labour leader of failing to tackle the racism festering among his supporters. And they dismissed his repeated public assertions that anti-Semitism is unacceptable and he will crack down on it as cheap words that are not backed up by action. They said Mr Corbyn has failed to follow through on his promises to speedily discipline Labour members behind the abuse. And they said they have lost faith in his words. Mr Lewis said, "But I am now the enemy from the right wing because I happen to say this populist movement under Jeremy Corbyn is dangerous for Jews and it's time for me to get out." John McDonnell, the closest ally to Jeremy Corbyn on the front bench, issued the angry intervention on Twitter last night as the party continues to tear itself apart over the scandal. A Labour Party spokesman said, "Jeremy Corbyn is a militant opponent of anti-Semitism. He is determined to eradicate all forms of it from the Labour Party and wider society." Labour accused Dame Margaret Hodge of being disconnected from reality in anti-Semitism row. Former Minister Margaret Hodge clashed angrily with Jeremy Corbyn last month as the row over Labour's new code of conduct raged. Labour launched an extraordinary attack on veteran MP Margaret Hodge today after she claimed a disciplinary probe into her anti-Semite jibe at Jeremy Corbyn made her feel like a Jew in Nazi Germany. A party spokesman accused Dame Margaret of being disconnected from reality after she spoke of her emotional response to being put under investigation. The former minister clashed angrily with Mr. Corbyn last month as the row over Labour's new code of conduct raged. She branded the leader an anti-Semite during a heated confrontation and refused to retract the comment, which Mr. Corbyn himself rejected. A disciplinary probe was announced but was later dropped after an outcry from Labour MPs. In an interview last night, Dame Margaret, who is Jewish and lost family in the Holocaust, said learning she was under investigation brought back fears of Nazi Germany. On the day that I heard that they were going to discipline me and possibly suspend me, it felt almost like, I kept thinking, what did it feel like to be a Jew in Germany in the 30s, she told Sky News, because it felt almost as if they were coming for me. It's rather difficult to define, but there's that fear, and it reminded me of what my dad used to say. He always said to me as a child, you've got to keep a packed suitcase at the door, Margaret, in case you ever have got to leave in a hurry. A Labour Party spokesman said, the comparison of the Labour Party's disciplinary process with Nazi Germany is so extreme and disconnected from reality it diminishes the seriousness of the issue of anti-Semitism. They said Mr Corbyn and the Labour Party are fully committed to support the Jewish community and the party has taken action to tackle the abuse and work to rebuild trust. The revelation comes as Labour MPs are in open warfare about the crisis and how to tackle it. Labour launched an extraordinary attack on veteran MP Margaret Hodge after she claimed a disciplinary probe into her anti-Semite jibe at Mr Corbyn made her feel like a Jew in Nazi Germany. A party spokesman accused Dame Margaret of being disconnected from reality after she spoke of her emotional response to being put under investigation. The former minister clashed angrily with Mr Corbyn last month as the row over Labour's new code of conduct raged. She branded the leader an anti-Semite during a heated confrontation, and refused to retract the comment, which Mr Corbyn himself rejected. In an interview last night, Dame Margaret, who is Jewish and lost family in the Holocaust, said learning she was under investigation brought back fears of Nazi Germany. On the day that I heard that they were going to discipline me and possibly suspend me, it felt almost like, I kept thinking, what did it feel like to be a Jew in Germany in the 30s, she told Sky News, because it felt almost as if they were coming for me. It's rather difficult to define, but there's that fear, and it reminded me of what my dad used to say. He always said to me as a child, you've got to keep a packed suitcase at the door, Margaret, in case you ever have got to leave in a hurry. And John McDonnell last night furiously accused Labour moderates of using the anti-Semitism crisis as cover for their secret plot to form a new party. In a loaded barb on Twitter, the shadow chancellor accused some of his backbenchers of conspiring for 2 years to split the Labour Party. And he warned them that any attempt to use the anti-Semitism row as justification for their plans would be seen as appalling cynicism. Several Labour moderates, including former leadership contender Chuck Ramuna and Chris Leslie, are said to be in talks to start a new centrist party. They are angry with Jeremy Corbyn's refusal to call for a second EU referendum and his failure to tackle the anti-Semitism crisis tearing their party apart. But Mr. McDonnell, one of the Labour leader's closest allies, said they are exploiting the racism row for their own political gains. He said, for anybody to use the issue of anti-Semitism as a cover for launching a new political party they had been planning for nearly 2 years would rightly be seen as an act of appalling cynicism, basically exploiting a genuine concern that people of goodwill are working hard to address.